Hey folks, my name's Ed Trevors. My pronouns are he, him, and his. Despite how I'm dressed, I am an Anglican priest serving in the beautiful parish of St. Margaret of Scotland that sits on the ancestral and the unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people, Gwe'e. I'm putting this video together just as a monthly update. I haven't done one in a little bit, and I wanted to let you know a few things about what's going on and how things are going. And immediately after I get this video uploaded, I'm going hiking with a friend here in Halifax. He tells me there's a few trails that we can do, and it's been way too long since I've spent any kind of time in the woods. So I'm really looking forward to that. First thing I want to talk about is the thing that I know is on everybody's mind, the beard. Ed, the beard is glorious. I can't tell you how many times I've heard that. I think I've heard it once. But the bottom line is I'm enjoying the beard. I'm really looking forward to seeing how it's going to fill out between now and the summertime when it's time to go racing in my laser. So that's kind of exciting. A few things about it. First, nobody told me that beards don't grow the way you want them. The hair grows in all kinds of different directions. I'm not a person that has curly hair, but someday you'll notice I've actually got a little bit of a curl, a wave to my beard on one side of my face. Where you see all the white, years ago, like 10, 15 years ago, when it was scruff, that was all red. So I'm a little disappointed in my Irish ancestry, my Irish-Scottish ancestry that has betrayed me in this way. Eating with a spoon and having a beard are incredibly difficult. It's not as simple as just, you either have to tilt your head back and let it, whatever's on the spoon, pour into your mouth, or you've got to find a way of flipping it and using your bottom lip to, otherwise you end up getting food particles and stuff, which is another thing that you find in a beard from time to time is stuff. You know, I was told in the last video where I talked about my beard, you got to brush it more, you got to comb it, and spare thee not the beard oil. That was good advice. Lots of beard oil, lots of oil. Keep that thing hydrated. Keep that thing from drying out. But when you're combing it, when you're brushing it, yeah, it's not uncommon to find things in there. Sometimes it's scary, but sometimes it's really quite, you know, you find a couple of coins, you find a couple of dollars, it's a good day. Anyway, the next thing I want to talk to you about is me. People have been asking where I am, how I'm doing. They've been asking, you know, because I haven't been producing as many videos as I was before, maybe by around September, October. But, you know, in fairness, being completely vulnerable and honest, the last couple of months have been kind of difficult. I have a difficult time with winter. Seasonal change. The skies are really gray. You don't get as much sunlight. The sun is farther away, so the sunlight you do get, you know, it's not quite as powerful. You can't go out and have your coat off. You're all bundled up, so your body doesn't absorb as much of it. I've heard all kinds of different reasons why I feel this way, but the bottom line is this winter has been really difficult, and I think partly it's also because we've gone into this Omicron thing. So we've gone into another partial lockdown here in Nova Scotia. Also, all the changes that I've gone through and that my family's gone through and that we're going through, I think all that stuff sort of came together in this perfect storm that has led me to a place of feeling depressed. And by that, I don't mean grief. I mean overwhelmed. Not quite certain where to turn, how to turn, where to go. And what that has done to me on a creative side is it's led me to this incredibly intolerable place of writer's block. And I've talked about my writer's block in the past where I need to be perfect. Everything I say needs to be perfect. Everything I do needs to be perfect. Everybody that I offer something to, they must love it. And if anybody has a question, if anybody has a comment, if anybody questions me or my motivations, then it doesn't feel quite right. I feel kind of shattered. But the truth is, nothing's ever perfect. All we can ever do is offer what we're inspired to offer. Do the best we can in that moment. And do better tomorrow if we learn something new. That's what my brain knows. Anyhow, we're working on it, dealing with it. I am feeling much better as time goes on. I appreciate your patience and your tolerance, and I appreciate you being a part of my life in the way that you have. It really has been important for me that you're out there, to hearing from you, to conversing with you from time to time, to hearing your questions, to hearing your concerns, to gathering your feedback. So thanks very much for all that you do to make this channel what it is. I really appreciate it. And thank you especially for being there for one another. That is absolutely incredible to me. And I know through my conversations with some how they benefit from your engagement, from everybody's engagement with one another. So please keep it up. On a church side of things, I'm going to post a link to St. Margaret of Scotland's Facebook page. On that page, you will... you'll be invited, if you become a member of that page, a friend of that page, if you like that page, however, follow that page, you will be invited to our services. And we do a Sunday morning service at 10:30. I know a lot of people, when I was in Shelburne, were always asking, are you ever able to do a Sunday morning service where we can see the Eucharist? I wasn't there because we didn't have the ability to live stream. Here we do. We have an amazing system here at St. Margaret. And we do live stream every morning, every Sunday morning at 10:30 Atlantic Standard Time, Halifax time. So if you're interested in being a part of that, you can check it out. If you're not able to catch it live, it's also there for your viewing pleasure later on. The other thing that we're doing here, and it's led by our choir director, Rebecca, she is doing Compline every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday night at 9 o'clock Atlantic Standard Time, Halifax time. Compline is an amazingly beautiful sung service. It's meant to be a prayer service that you would end your day with. You know, it's about letting go of what was. It's about asking for protection over the course of the night and asking for God's presence in your life over the course of the night and preparing ourselves for the work to be done tomorrow. Compline is a beautiful service. And Rebecca is so incredibly talented musically. She does an amazing job. And we're actually building up a group of people that are helping her sing Compline. So if you're interested at all in that, 9 o'clock, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Atlantic Standard Time, the Facebook link will be in the comments, pinned right up there at the top. Last thing, but certainly not the least important, the last thing I want to mention is Patreon. You Patreon supporters out there, thank you so much for what you're doing. In the time that I've been here in Halifax, I've discovered all kinds of different organizations in the community that are looking for help. So last month, we were able to help a food bank that operates out of one of our sister parishes here in town, St. Mark's Food Bank, out of the parish of St. Mark's. We don't have that kind of ministry here at St. Margaret. It's just not the demographic that lives around us. So instead of trying to recreate something somebody else is already doing, we support them in what they're doing. So last month, the Patreon team here, we were able to support St. Mark's Food Bank. We were also able to support a group that works with Halifax's homeless population called Halifax Mutual Aid. We did stuff for them. We were also, because it was close to Christmas, we helped out some individuals prepare themselves for Christmas, get themselves in order. In some cases to prepare for their Christmas dinners, some cases to buy their family gifts. So over the course of December and January, the money that came in through Patreon went out to various local agencies here in Halifax, Halifax Mutual Aid and the food bank at St. Mark's, and it went out to individuals who I won't name to help them with their lives. Coming up in the future, there is an amazing, and this was a church that I was actually a student at years ago. They have a minister there right now, a fellow I graduated with, Father Nick. They have a soup kitchen. St. George's Soup Kitchen operates out of St. George's Anglican Church here in Halifax. Next month, we have a gentleman in our church. If you've followed our services before, Danny, he's preached here and he's going to be leading services this week, but I'm going off topic. Anyway, Danny has it in his heart to help out the folks at St. George's Soup Kitchen. Again, it's not a ministry we have, so we support other parishes in doing their work. And Danny is going to organize a weekend where we go and we prepare a lunch for anybody who needs it. I want to say it's 150 to 160 people. And that's where the Patreon funds that come in over the next month or so will go to help out with that, help out with the costs for that. Can't thank you enough. If you're interested in supporting some of these ministries that my family's taken on and that we continue to take on, please check out our Patreon site. It's always available in the description. Check out our Patreon account. It's always available in the description. Thank you so much for those of you that are helping. Thank you so much to those who want to help. Just having a desire to help means the world to me. So God bless you all. With that being said, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord keep you, may the Lord's face be made to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord's countenance be lifted up to you. May you always know the peace of being in the Lord's presence. And I pray, well, my prayer today is one of gratitude. I am so thankful for each and every one of you. I'm thankful for what you offer me. I'm thankful for what you offer each other. This is the power of community. And what I see more often than not in this community is people raising each other up, people challenging one another, people encouraging growth, people offering opportunity. God bless you all. Thank you all. Amen. Numultus.